Henry James's ghost novella, The Turn of the Screw, was first published in 1898 and has been repeatedly hailed as an innovation in the genre. That innovation? Well, it's impossible to tell whether the protagonist is really seeing ghosts or whether the whole thing is in her head. The consensus among commentators today seems to be that there isn't enough information in the story to make a firm decision either way, but the idea that this is what makes it original persists. I'm not sure it is original, at least in that regard. There's an assumption among English scholars that subgenres such as weird fiction and the ghost story cannot move in advance of fiction more generally. Once one has a handle on the majority report, one can read off the minority report, in this case the matter of innovation in the subgenres, by a process of deduction. This sort of view is reinforced by seasoned academicians who tell us that the ghost story is really about something else, colonialism or sex or class. I disagree. I think that, for example, weird fiction was considerably in advance of literary fiction for the better part of the 20th century. Literary fiction finally caught up with it in the work of Borges, Ballard and the magical realists. In order to assess the originality or not of The Turn of the Screw, one needs to set it in the context of other ghost stories. It's told within a framing device, so of course one can't tell whether the report is veridical or not. The same thing happens with the three ghost stories in Sheridan Le Fanu's In a Glass Darkly, published a full 16 years before James's novella. And try and tell me whether the ghost in H.G. Wells' 1896, The Red Room, is real or not. In nearly all good ghost stories, it's possible to say that the phantom might or might not be a figment of the protagonist's imagination. That's how ghosts work. In the most celebrated ghost story in the English language, M.R. James's O Whistle and I'll Come to You, who's to say that the bedsheets weren't just bedsheets? What we're left with is that Henry James did subjectivity remarkably well, and that The Turn of the Screw is an exceptionally good ghost story. But sorry, that's not enough to salvage the radical innovation in the ghost story claims.